Hey guys, this is Lee here, and in this video, I'm going to share with you three important rule changes for the Sunfish sailboat that are going to be placed in effect immediately this season. But before I get to these really important changes, I'd like to ask you to please subscribe to the channel. It helps the channel out a lot. And also smash that like button until fireworks come out of the thumb. And that helps share the video with like-minded sailors just like you. So I really appreciate it. And now to the video. So rule change number one, for our Mark III sails are going to be allowed to be used in regional and world qualifying events starting this season. What prompted this was FARA Sails from Connecticut, USA, made a sizable donation to the decision makers of the class. The class decision makers decided to make this rule change immediately effective in 2022. You can get their newest iteration of their sail, which is the Mark III. I'll leave a link down in the description below. The sails have been proven to be able to point higher than normal racing sails, and they're actually larger in square footage. And because they're made of Mylar see-through, you can actually see the competitor's whole sail as a big window. Now, to offset the costs of these new sails, if you really want to, you don't need to have them because the old sails will be able to be used in world qualifying events. But FARA Sails is giving a 25% discount for the first year, so I'll leave a link down in the description below. So after the 25% off of their original cost of $1,200, the sale is only going to be $900. Rule change number two for the Sunfish class effective immediately. Digital compasses are going to be able to be used. However, but the addition of being able to detect headers and lifts will be able to be used in all digital compasses. This was determined by the class decision makers that knowing the headers and the lifts really doesn't give the average sailor an advantage, because if you're an average sailor, you're going to be in bad air anyway. So even if you know the lift or the tack, you're probably going to be in bad disturbed air. So it really doesn't matter. So if you want to have the ability to read headers and lifts digitally, by all means, you're now allowed to use it. I researched a couple of compasses where they have the abilities to detect lifts and headers, and I'll leave them in the description down below. The cost is only about $600, so it's pretty affordable. Now, the third and last rule change that's going to be placed into effect immediately is the elimination of the second halyard. They're also going to eliminate anything that resembles a Jens rig, a Gust Adjust, or a Mendelblatt rig. Because the decision makers of the class saw that you need an extra long halyard. It has to go up to the top of the mast. It has to be really thin. And the only time you could use really thin non-stretch line, as you could see in my Jens video, which now is basically worthless, is that it needs to be high tech. And that high tech line can get very expensive. So the class decided to eliminate the possibility of using a Jens rig, Mendelblatt rig, because they want everyone to be on a fair playing surface. They don't want the Sunfish sailboat to be an arms race for whoever has the most money will have the better boat. So what do you think about these three rule changes? Would you change anything about the rules? Let me know in the comment section down below. I read all the comments. So that's it for this short video. I really appreciate you watching. Please don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you on the water. And happy April Fool's Day.